It turns out that content distribution networks and ISPs have a fairly symbiotic relationship when it comes to peering relationships. CDNs like to peer with ISPs because peering directly with ISPs where a customer is located provides better throughput, since there are no intermediate AS hops and network latency is lower. Having more vectors to deliver content increases reliability, and during large request events, having direct connectivity to multiple networks where the content is hosted allows an ISP to spread its traffic across multiple transit links, thereby potentially reducing the 95th percentile and lowering its transit costs. On the other hand, there are other good reasons for ISPs to peer with CDNs. First of all, providing content closer to the ISP's customers allows the ISP to provide the customers with good performance for a particular service. For example, you could already see that Georgia Tech has placed a Google cache node in its own network, resulting in very low latencies to Google, and thereby happy customers. You can imagine that providing good performance to popular services is a major selling point for ISPs. Another reason that ISPs like to peer with CDNs or host cache nodes locally is to lower their transit costs. You can imagine that if there were huge demand for a particular video on YouTube, and all of the requests and responses were going over expensive transit links, then the ISP's costs would be potentially prohibitively high. On the other hand, peering with a CDN or hosting a local cache node prevents all of that traffic from traversing expensive links, thus reducing costs.